Hey beauties, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing 10 game-changing luxury beauty products that make me feel flawless. They elevate my makeup routine, and those occasions that I'm really putting in the time, I want my makeup to look its very best. These are some of the products that I lean on continuously. I've seen a lot of creators do this tag recently, so that's what inspired me. I think the first person I saw was Patty Alonso a couple months ago, and then I recently watched Morgan Turner's video. So in case you really like this idea, if you're a fan of the concept, I will link both of their videos down below in the description box. That way you can check them out right after this. But if it's your first time here, welcome, I'm so happy you found me. This is our pink sparkly bubble on YouTube where we talk about luxury, beauty, fragrance, fashion, everything glam. So if that sounds good to you, join our community by subscribing and don't forget to hit the notification bell. I am of course wearing all of these products on my face today, so as I talk about each one, I can show you the application. So I'm going to present them in the order in which I applied them, or else that would be very strange to follow along. So the very first item is my primer today, and this is the By Terry Brightening CC Serum. I have the shade Sunny Flash right here. I also own the Rose Elixir. And they're interchangeable. I love them both. I want to own all four because this truly is one of my favorite products. What's great about the Sunny Flash is that it has a little luminosity to it. It also has skincare built in, but the luminosity is subtle enough that if I wanted to wear this by itself with no foundation, I absolutely could, and it gives that naturally flawless appearance. It also has a bronze tint to it, so it looks like you've been sun-kissed without actually having to step out in the sun. So generally, I like to use this over the summer. It's still 100 degrees outside, so I can still use this now, even though it's the end of October. But in the next few months, I will switch over to my Rose Elixir because I think that one is a little bit more wintry. It's very ethereal, gives a very soft glow underneath makeup. It's very thin, so I never feel like it's too heavy to layer foundation and the rest of my makeup on top. It fills in fine lines and pores. It does have skincare. It contains white rose and I think a few other things. You have to give it a really nice shake. You can apply it with your fingers. I applied it with a brush today. And something else I like to do is I will bring this down my neck, chest décolleté. If I were wearing something completely off the shoulder, I would apply this to my entire chest. And once it dries down and it's not sticky and it's not greasy, it just makes your skin look beautiful. Absolutely stunning. Great for the holidays. And I believe it comes in four different shades. The next product that makes me feel flawless is the foundation, and today I'm wearing Dior Air Flash. Because when I think of a flawless face or flawless complexion, I don't necessarily equate that to completely full coverage. So I was going through my foundations thinking, what is the foundation that makes me feel flawless? There were a couple front runners. It could have been Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless. It could have been the Chanel Ultra Latent. That's another foundation that I like to use for photos when I want my skin to look completely even, you know, not a lot of natural skin shining through. But that's what's so great about Air Flash, and that's why I went back to this, is because it's thin enough that it does even out your complexion. It does help hide any sort of discoloration or uneven skin tone, but it also doesn't feel heavy. It never looks like a mask. And your skin does shine through a little bit, and it just looks so natural. This is the most natural looking flawless complexion I think you can create, is using Dior Air Flash. So I like to give it a shake, of course. I spray this directly on my brush. I like to start in the center of the face and blend out, because I usually do have to go in with a couple different sprays. It can be a bit tricky figuring out how much product to use, because of course you don't want to waste it. And with a traditional foundation with a pump, you're just gonna go in one pump, two pumps, and that's what you'll use for your face and body, and you can kind of get it down pat so that you know exactly how much you're gonna use, how much you need to pump out. With the spray, I like to do short little bursts on the brush, but I'll start out slow with a small amount and then build it up from there. So you really can customize how much coverage you want. If you want really light coverage, Dior Air Flash can give you light coverage. If you want full coverage, you can absolutely build this up. So that's another great thing about it, is it's versatile, it photographs beautifully, it's long wearing. It's only a top 10 list, so not all of the products that I use today are going to be mentioned. Of course, everything will be listed down below, but in case you're interested, the concealer I have on today is the Pat McGrath Labs. I just pulled it out of the drawer without really putting too much thought into it, because the third product is actually the Sisley Eye Contour Mask. This product definitely makes me feel flawless. I'm not sure if it makes me feel flawless, because I guess it's not really a makeup item, but it makes me feel confident in my makeup. Confident that no matter what concealer I use, it's not going to crease, and my under eyes will not look dry later on in the day. I rave about this product, and I recommend it to absolutely everybody who struggles with their concealer creasing or dryness around their eyes. I always use eye cream, and I would say this does not replace your eye cream. Go in with your normal skincare, but then use a little bit of this on top. And today I accidentally applied a little bit too much. I was trying to show you just how much I use. It's not a lot. A teeny tiny bit is all you need. And I like to pat it either right before I apply my concealer. Sometimes I mix it into my concealer. If you need to, you can go on top of your concealer. And that's actually how this was first introduced to me. People sometimes ask me, how did you start using the product like that? When I read about it, it says it's actually an eye contour mask. During a Sisley brand training several years ago when I worked for Nordstrom, the educator had me tap a little bit on top of my concealer, and I noticed that day, the very first time I used it, that later on in the afternoon, my under eyes still felt really soft, really supple, really hydrated, and that had never been the case previously. So it was love at first sight with this product, and I've never looked back. You can use it as a mask if you want to apply a thicker layer, if you want to keep this in a skincare refrigerator or a regular refrigerator and apply a thicker layer, leave it on for about 10 minutes and then you can tissue off the excess. Or you can apply it like I do, a little bit with your concealer. I like to use it as a mask occasionally, but I find that the greatest impact is when I apply this with my concealer. What a difference. Days that I do not use this with my concealer, because every once in a while, you know, I get busy, I'll just skip it. I can tell. My concealer creases, my under eyes look incredibly dry. All of these little fine lines that I have around my eyes are more prominent on days that I skip the Sisley Eye Contour Mask. The next product that makes me feel flawless is one that I save for special occasions, and I really need to stop doing that. I'm trying to break that habit because it's terrible. Why should we save all of our favorite makeup for a couple days out of the year? I want to start using all of my favorite makeup, the products that I love to use that make me feel my very best. This is definitely one of them. It's the Giorgio Armani Microfill Loose Powder. I have the shade pink. They also have a bronze and a pearl. This powder is so nice because when you look, it has a very slight iridescent sheen. Sort of similar to the Lancôme Absolute Powder. I think it's a little bit more subtle. It's not shimmer, it's not glitter. I don't think you could use this as a powder highlight unless you just prefer a very soft and subtle highlight. For most people, it is going to be more of a setting powder, but it's dramatic as a setting powder, so you have to be careful. It's sort of a funny thing. When I apply this powder, I use the teeny tiniest bit, and then I put my brush down. You have to stop. As soon as you apply to the skin, you see that sheen and you think, oh wow, this is so beautiful, like, ooh, I'm glowing. And you're tempted to go back for more and build it up because it's so beautiful. You think, ooh, I want to add more to my face. Do not do that. That is the mistake you will make with this powder. I've made that mistake several times. It's hard to come back from because once the powder's on your face, there's not much you can do about it. So you just have to make sure you use such a small amount. I always tap off any excess. In fact, I used this in conjunction with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. I also like to use this to set my under eyes because it's very finely milled. It's very soft and light, and it's also brightening. So I kind of mixed the two. I went in with a little bit of this first just to set the concealer and get rid of shine. But then to restore that glow that I want with my makeup, I went in with a little bit of this on top. So it's nice to have the combination of both because that powder is flat matte. This powder has the soft ethereal glow. It is so pretty. It's very bridal. It's very spring, but it just makes you look healthy, glowing. It makes you look happy. The next product that makes me feel flawless is this Gucci bronzer, shade 3. This is my favorite bronzer that launched this summer. The texture is unlike most of the bronzers I own in that it is very creamy, and I think that's what sets this apart. It blends and glides on the skin in such a way that it is incredibly natural. And this is a pretty deep shade. It's going to give you color. But as long as you go in and you slowly build, it almost looks like an airbrushed bronze. And this bronzer does have a little bit of luminosity to it, so it has a very natural skin finish. I just find that this shade, this texture, is ideal for me. There is no other bronzer that I love more than this one. Even the Chanel Sunset bronzer, that's probably a close second. But that powder, as finely milled and easy to blend as it is nowhere near as creamy as this, or as pigmented. I think you can really build this up. And although it is completely unrelated to why this bronzer makes me feel flawless, I love this packaging. And there's just something about beautiful luxury packaging whenever I take this out of the little velvet protector and I apply it to my face. Whenever I travel with this compact, it just feels really special. And the product inside is beautiful to boot. So it's just kind of the perfect compact. Blush is a funny product because if you're like me and you love blush, every single blush you own makes you feel flawless. It doesn't matter what the shade is, what the brand, what the texture. I just love blush. So as I was going through my collection picking out that one perfect blush, I narrowed down maybe a top five list and then I just pulled out the one that I use the most, and that is this NARS Liquid Orgasm. It's not that I use it the most, because I'm always trying new makeup, it's not that I use it the most consistently, but I would say whenever I'm just sitting down doing my makeup for myself, I'm not filming a video, I'm not testing out a product, I'm just doing my makeup to go out on a date night, something like that. This is the blush that I grab most often. I moved it and I can't seem to find it at the moment. Quintessence, Evening Beige, I just pulled out Rosewood. That's another one. There are so many Chanel blushes that I love and I just think they're classic. But besides those, I really like a liquid cream cheek. And if I had to choose one, it would be this NARS Liquid Orgasm. I always talk about picking up other shades. It's really thin, so you have to give it a good shake. I use the teeny tiniest bit on the back of my hand because it is really pigmented. And then I go in with a traditional blush brush. Just kind of wipe it around, pick it up on the brush, and then I tap it on the cheeks. It never disrupts my makeup underneath. I never have to worry about my foundation breaking up or it looking patchy. It just goes on and it blends beautifully. I think part of that is using a really soft, fluffy brush. I just had to take a 20-minute break because the rain and the lightning got so loud. This room was shaking. We had a mini monsoon out there, so it is now past. I am back in action. This next product I have here to talk about is from Guerlain. It's the Gold Terracotta Skin Highlighting Stick, one of my all-time favorite cream highlights. It definitely makes you feel flawless. It makes your skin look naturally flawless. It's a really subtle glow, and I usually like a highlight that beams off the cheek. But this is more, it's gold. It's more of a flesh tone. It's a really soft, pale gold, and that's what makes it so beautiful, is that it looks like your skin is glowing. It doesn't look like pink or pearl or some sort of other colored highlighter is beaming off your cheek. It looks like your skin is just glowing. Because it's a little bit more subtle, I love to apply this to the chin, the nose, the tops of the eyebrows. You can really apply it so many places other than the tops of the cheeks. And again, it just looks like your skin is really luminous and naturally dewy. Not a lot of representation here for eyes, but I do have one product. It's actually a group of products, but I'm considering it to be one product because this is the brow. Brows make such a huge difference with your makeup overall, and sometimes you just have a bad day, and on a bad brow day, it's a bad makeup day. So here I have the three main products in my current routine. I have the Benefit Brow Microfilling Pen, Precisely My Brow Pencil, shade 4, and the 24-Hour Brow Setter Gel. This stuff is amazing, the best brow gel. I do have a complete tutorial where I go in depth with these products. I will link it down below in case you're interested. But I love using these products. This is my go-to perfect brow routine. Sometimes I run out of time or I just don't feel like putting in the time and I'm having a lazy makeup day. And those days, I just fill them in with the Precisely My Brow Pencil. But those are not my flawless makeup days. Those are days that I'm just being really minimal. On days that I really feel my best, it's when I've put in the time and I've gone through each step. The microfilling pen first, especially in the front of the brow, and then I fill in any of the blank spots with the Precisely My Brow pencil, always set with the gel. I generally don't skip this step. Sometimes if I'm just running errands, I just fill them in a little bit and then I don't worry about the gel, but this is the killer trio. The best brow routine, brow situation I have ever had. This is the happiest I've ever been with my brows. I'm so happy I discovered these. These were sent to me complimentary from Benefit. And since they've sent me the little care box, I've purchased several brow products on my own whenever I see them go on sale because I just won't go back to anything else. I have two products here left to talk about. So number 9 is my lipstick. Today I am wearing the Le Rouge Duo Ultra Tenue from Chanel in the shade Passionate Red. And I was really just looking for any red. I would say this lipstick formula makes me feel flawless, whether it's a nude, a pink, a mauve, berry, red, doesn't matter. I just feel the most confident with this lipstick formula. I know I talk about it all the time, it's my favorite, because it's long wearing, it feels really nice, but it looks good for a long period of time. If it was just long wearing, but after a couple of hours it felt uncomfortable and it looked really patchy, it wouldn't be my favorite. The reason I love it is because I can throw it on in the morning, and if I have a long day, or if I'm just go, go, go nonstop, later on in the day, I haven't even had a moment to think about lipstick, but I'll look in the mirror, I'll catch a glimpse of myself, and I think, oh, okay, you don't look crazy. It's not as bad as you thought, because this lipstick is just so consistent. It is there for you, it has your back, and I wanted to choose the perfect red. Of the two reds I own, Burning Red and Passionate Red, I think this one is my favorite. And it's kind of perfect for fall, winter, holiday parties, special events. It's a deeper red, it's more dramatic. And I think there's a lot of power to the perfect red lip. This would be my flawless lip choice. Whenever I film, I catch myself referencing holiday parties and special events and occasions and date nights, all of these things that I haven't been doing, none of us have been doing for the last couple of months, because I have hope that at some point things will sort of return to normal. Maybe it won't be this holiday season, maybe we have to wait until spring, but I have faith that at some point in the near future, we might have to wait a little while, but it's coming before we know it. We will have an opportunity to wear our favorite lipsticks and do a full face of glam makeup, and somebody other than our significant other or our roommate or our neighbors, our dogs, will see us. So, fingers crossed. And in the meantime, we can apply our flawless face for ourselves. We are worth it. I like to get up in the morning and do my makeup, get dressed, spray on perfume. It just makes me feel better. I'm more productive in the other things that I have going on that have nothing to do with makeup, that are not beauty related, when I look and feel better. So I know for me, it is good for my mental health to put these products to use and throw on a bright lipstick every once in a while. And then last but not least, this product might seem kind of random, and yet it was one of the first items that I knew belonged on the list. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. Before this setting spray launched, a couple months ago, earlier in the year, I didn't really put a lot of thought, time, effort into setting sprays. I have several that I really like, but I look at them more as a skincare step, or if my face is feeling sort of dry, I'll spritz them on, or I just spritz them on just to feel good, and they smell nice, they feel great, it's kind of like a little luxury. This is heavy-duty makeup setting spray. I notice a difference whenever I use this setting spray. Not only does it make your makeup look very dewy, it kind of gives you a glass, plastic doll kind of finish. Maybe that's not what you're going for, but it makes you look very shiny and luminous. I would not be surprised if I found out this was hairspray, because that's kind of the same effect. I don't think it is hairspray. I think there's actually skincare benefits in this, but it just holds everything in place. You know, it has this glossy finish. It sets your makeup so that it doesn't budge. Later on in the day, yeah, you're gonna look a little bit shiny, but also everything is going to be exactly where you want it to be. So I love this setting spray. It makes me feel flawless. It makes me feel like my makeup is not going anywhere every time I apply this setting spray. And then I do have a little final honorable mention here. This is the Babe Lash Essential Serum, the lash serum that I've been using consistently for the last couple of months. I know I've talked about this in a couple favorites videos, but at the time, I just Googled it, found a couple links somewhere online, anywhere I could find it cheap. But I contacted Babe Lash this week and I just said, hey, I use your lash serum and I've had so much success. I'd love to share it with my subscribers. They do have an affiliate program, so I signed up. So I have a link, but the most important thing is that I have a discount code. So AerinNicoleTV20 at checkout saves you 20% off of this lash serum for anybody who's been curious. I know I have seen a huge difference and some of you guys have noticed with my lashes too. The Babe Lash is amazing. It works. You do have to be consistent. I keep it in the bathroom right next to my toothbrush and all of my other evening skincare. So I just make it part of my routine and that way I don't forget about it. Wow. After 6 weeks, I think I probably saw full results. Night and day difference from my natural lashes, which are not terrible, but they're not great. This makes your lashes look like falsies and it's amazing. It will make you feel flawless because it doesn't matter if you have an expensive mascara or the cheapest mascara on the market, your lashes are going to look incredible when they're naturally really long and strong because it doesn't just add length and volume, but the lash itself, it's like the hair that grows out of your head. It's kind of weird. I feel like I could comb through them and detangle them because they're just super lashes. And that completes my list of beauty products that make me feel flawless. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Leave me your comments, questions down below. I want to hear from you guys. What are the products that you use when you want to look and feel your very best? Drop me a comment. We'll keep the conversation going there. As always, I will be linking everything mentioned, everything on my face down in the description box for your convenience. And for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell.